only place to get up close and personal with the ultimate predators of the sea. Celebrating the true kings of the ocean. Don't miss Shark Fest. All next week with Friends at 7 on Nat Geo Wild.
He was relaxed, he was grazing, he was just moving on his own time. And then we saw there's a little bit of a thickish grass patchy area. And we thought, okay, we'll creep down to that. And you can see this bear is a big bear. And you know he can outrun you. The closer we got, the more nervous you got. And I got closer and closer and closer. And the dart went and the bear took off. It was like, ah, okay, we've got him.
Irrespective of the size of the animal, a dart hits and it discharges deep intramuscularly. The effects and timing of anesthetics are fairly predictable, depending on how much stimulation there is and how much adrenaline is in circulation, because the adrenaline does counteract some of the anesthetic types. But generally, from dart impact, within 5 minutes, that animal should be heavily off balance, if not recumbent down on the ground. In this case, we don't have that. What becomes very obvious is that when this animal is hit with the first dart, that you have a partial discharge. And when an animal goes into anesthesia, there are different stages. And the first stage of anesthetic is a massive excitatory phase.
Hitting a large wild animal with a dart is like poking it with a stick. The animal gets riled up. The adrenaline starts to surge, triggering fight or flight. That's the excitatory phase before the tranquilizer kicks in.
Normally, when an animal is given a very large volume of anesthetic drug, it bypasses this excitatory phase fairly quickly, and then the animal drops and you go into different levels of anesthetic. Unfortunately, in this case, because there is only partial discharge and partial absorption of the drug, this animal goes into a massive excitatory phase where it is then stimulated and carries on running. And this is quite dangerous for both the dart gun operator and the animal itself.
You realize that with the crawling, the dart has moved down the barrel. It doesn't get its full prediction. This would be last minute button to get the drug in fully. And the bear had now half the drug and he was running. He went up now. We had found a good couple of 100 feet that we wouldn't have reached. And we had to run after this guy as well. And by the time we got to the top, we were pretty out of breath. You know, we were probably ended up at about 16,500 feet. Now that's pretty high. The bear stood up there. And we didn't want to make it another dart, no dart. But the second dart goes off. It's quite dangerous because this bear is now a partial anesthetic effects, which could change its own behavior. And this is an excitatory effect. This animal changes from flight into fight. And the bear gap. We've got known by the darkies, another big issue, and the bear's coming.
Unless any of this ground team was an athletics long distance sprinter, it is exceptionally unlikely that anybody would be able to outrun this bear on the ground.
And the bear is coming towards us. The bear turned around and said, guys, get to the rocks there. We can at least run around the rocks and they would struggle a little bit about that. My camera system was silent. He's taking a different direction. But then the bear changed direction and I was chasing my camera system. And I could see on the camera that the bear was actually catching. I then shout, what was that? He just took off.
quite believe that I had sharpened the mandate. The vendor also said, had I not sharpened, that bear would have possibly pulled up with it and brought you to the ground. You have to regard any animal in the wild as a wild animal, and they can be very unpredictable. So you need to respect that animal. It isn't wild.
Once the tranquilizer wears off, most darted animals wake up without ill effects.
We were camped in the South Awanga National Park in Zambia. We were travelling between camps early one morning, around about 10 o'clock.
As we were travelling along, we got to see some amazing